This video is based on a new optimization algorithm that is inspired by game. First, we will start with introduction, then what is this algorithm all about, how it is working, various mathematical models used in this algorithm for players' movements and other activities, and then we have algorithm flowchart. As we all know, a number of optimization problems exist in different areas, such as in scientific areas, industrial areas, in engineering. And optimization algorithms are used to solve such problems. Matter-heuristic optimization algorithms are widely accepted to solve optimization problems as they provide promising results. As you can see here, matter-heuristic algorithms are classified into different categories: evolutionary algorithms, nature-inspired algorithms, physics-based algorithms, chemistry-based algorithms, art-based algorithms, bio-inspired algorithms. So we have a number of algorithms that are already proposed by different researchers that are inspired by insects, birds, animals, art, bio, physics, chemistry, and other. Now we will try to understand a new optimization algorithm that is named as Battle Royale optimization algorithm. This is a recently proposed meta-heuristic optimization algorithm that is inspired by Battle Royale video games. As we all know, population-based meta-heuristic optimization algorithms start with initial population of agents, or you can say candidate solution, and then on the randomly initialized population, we will apply the optimization algorithm. And then we will obtain a set of solution, and then we will find out the best among all, and we will consider this as final output. For meta-heuristic algorithms, exploration and exploitation phases play major role. These are the two key components that should be balanced. Exploration phase refers to the investigation phase where we discover new solution in the problem space. Exploitation phase refers to the local search. For every meta-heuristic algorithm, these two phases should be balanced so that we can avoid algorithm falling into local optimum. Now we will try to understand how Battle Royale optimization algorithm is working and how this algorithm is inspired by game and what are the key components that we are using from video games. Before 21st century, Battle Royale word refers to fight games such as boxing games, wrestling games, and action games. These games are fought until one player or fighter remains standing. In 21st century, Battle Royale word taken new meaning, that is fictional narrative mode of entertainment that is also known as death games, killing games. Battle Royale video games are inspired by a Japanese film, Battle Royale. In Battle Royale video games, a group of players or people are instructed to kill one another, and the aim is to be the last player or team standing by eliminating or by killing other players. As you can see here, we have different types of game. One player game where only one individual can play at a time. Two player games where two individuals can play any game at a time. Battle Royale video games are multiplayer video games where multiple players can play all together digital platform. Now you can see we have key components for Battle Royale video games. Battle Royale video games can be played as individual versus individual, in pairs where two players can play against each other or all together. And the key advantage of Battle Royale video games is multiple players can play all together on digital platform. Here you can see in the battle royale video games we have space. Players can explore the space, and for the survival they need to kill one another and they need to protect themselves so that they can survive throughout the game. And initially all players are given with minimal resources such as equipments, weapons and other resources, and they can utilize their surrounding for their survival in order to escape from attackers, and they can also find out different resources in the surrounding. And then you can see we have here safe zone. Safe zone is the play zone, or you can say play area, and players have to remain in the play zone throughout the game. And if any player cross this zone, then either they are eliminated or certain damage. So here you can see game area is also shrinking as different phases passes. So all the players should remain inside the play zone. And player length in battle royale video games, it depends from game to game. Almost it can be 12 to 100 people. Now you can see here we have battle royale optimization algorithm. So like other meta heuristic optimization algorithm, first we will initialize with population that is randomly initialized. So here we have randomly initialized population of players. We will distribute the players in the search space, and each player have weapons for their survival, and players at the better position can harm other. And if any player is hurt by another, then we will increase the damage level, and we will immediately change the damaged player position. And you can see here in the battle royale video games, game area also shrink. So we will shrink the problem space, and after that we will check whether stopping criteria is matched or not. If stopping criteria is matched, then we will display the best player as solution. In the battle royale video games, we have winner as one player or a team. But in this algorithm, we will consider the best solution, that is the one solution, as the final output. Now let's try to understand how this algorithm is working. So first we will initialize the population randomly and all the important parameters. So in some games, players jumped from plane and parachute down onto the map somewhere randomly. So we will initialize the population of virtual players and uniformly distribute them in the problem space. And each individual is considered as player. As we know, players will try to kill each other for their survival throughout the game. So how they can kill each other? They can shoot with weapon. They have different weapons and other resources so that they can kill each other and survive throughout the game. For this behavior, they will initialize all the important parameters in step 2. Now in step 3, you can see here when player will hurt one another, we will increase their damage level by 1. In the video games, when any player is hurted by another player or by the attackers, then lifeline decrease. As you can see here, this player is damaged by this one. So you can see here, this is the player lifeline before damage, and now you can see now player is damaged being attacked by him. Now you can see here player lifeline after damage, and when this lifeline is empty, player is considered as dead. Now in step 3, when any player will hurt one another, we will increase their damage level by 1. So mathematically we can calculate player damage as this. So player damage is equal to, they will increment 1 in their damage level. Here xi means I is the player number, and we have value for I 1 to n, that is 1 to population size. Now you can see here step 4, exploitation phase. As you can see here, this player is now hurted by him. Now if this player will remain in this position again, he can shoot or hurt him. So now we will quickly move the damaged player into safe position so that he can survive throughout the game. Now we can move the damaged player in between the previous position and the best position. If this player will remain in the previous position, it means here, then this person can easily target him. So we need to move the damaged player somewhere in between previous and the best position, and we can calculate this behavior mathematically using this equation. Here R is the normally distributed random value within the range 0 and 1, and this is the best position, and here you can see this is the player position. Now you can see here, if the damaged player hurt their opponent in the next iteration, then we will reset player damage to 0. If you will play video games, you know, in between certain powers are given to the players, or while they are searching their surrounding, they can explore different resources, they can refill their life. So this behavior, if damaged player hurt their opponent in the next iteration, then we will reset the player damage to 0. That is, for any player, if it is being hurt by another, and in the next iteration, if anyhow it is hurting another player, then we will reset his damage level to 0. Now in step 6, we have exploration phase. Now you can see here, now if the player damage level exceed then the predefined threshold, then we will consider that player as dead, and we will respawn or reappear that player again. Now in the game, suppose this player is now killed by the attacker. Now in the video games, once the player is being killed by the attackers, then game over, and you can play again, continue game, or you can exit. For this behavior, check the damage level for the player. If it is exceed then the predefined threshold value, then the player is dead, then player dies and we will reswarm that player. It means we will randomly relocate that player somewhere, and we will reset the damage level again 0. Why? Because now game is over. So once the game is over, and if you continue the game, you will be without any damage, life is full. So we will reset now damage level again 0. So you can see here, we have the equation for the player coming back into the game space after being killed. Using this equation, we can relocate the player randomly in the problem space and reset the damage level 0. This is the lower bound, this is the upper bound, this is the dimension, and R is any random value that is normally distributed between 0 and 1. Now in step 7, as we know, the game area is shrinking, it is decreasing in every phase. So in every iteration, we will shrink the game area toward the best solution. So initially they will start the value for this, as you can see here, and then we will update it, and then in the step 8 we will select the best player as solution. Now you can see the flow chart for this algorithm. First we will randomly initialize the players in the problem space, and initialize all the important parameters, and then we will compare the ith player with their neighbors or the near one, that is the jth player, and then we will check the damage, whether the damage is greater than threshold value or it is less than threshold value. Threshold value can be set by using error and trial method. If this condition is true, then we will randomly relocate the damaged player and then increment the damage level by 1. If this condition is not true, then we will relocate using this equation, damage level is to 0, and then update their fitness values, and after that we will shrink the problem space, and then we will check whether the stopping criteria is matched or not. If stopping criteria is matched, then stop and display the best player as the solution. If stopping criteria is not matched, then repeat this loop from here by comparing ith player with the nearest one, and repeat all these steps. So that's all about this video. If you have any question, you can comment below, and thanks for watching this video.